Myself, Mr. R. Patil, Head of the Electronics Department, KBP Mahavidyalaya Pandharpur. Today there is a lecture for BSc 1, Semester 1, Paper 1st, that is the Digital Fundamentals. The first chapter from this paper is the number systems. There are four types of the number systems. These number systems are decimal number system, second is the binary number system, third is the octal number system, and fourth is the hexadecimal number system. Initially we have to see what is the decimal number system. Decimal number system is known to the human being for last hundreds of years, and which is the most popular number system that is used by the human being. This number system, introduction of this number system, we have to see in short. This number system has 10 digits, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. These are the 10 digits used in this number system. That is, 10 is the base or ranks of this system. 10 digits used, hence it is called as the decimal number system. It is a positional bit system. Positional bit system means the position of a digit in a given number decides its value. For example, if we have a number like this, then this 7 is at its unit's position, therefore its value is simply 7. While 3 is at 10th position, therefore its value is 30. While 2 is at 100th location, and therefore its value is 200. That is, this 7, its position bit is 10^2. This 3 has the position bit as 10^1. This has position bit of 10^2, and so on. Suppose we have a number like this. Then this 6 has the position weight of 10^-1, this 9 has a position weight of 10^-2, and so on. This number system is most popular, but this number system is not suitable for the computer or other machines which can be does the operation on the numbers, and therefore this is because this number system contains large number of digits. Instead of that, the another number system was suggested, and that number system was the binary number system. Binary number system, the name itself indicates that this number system contains only two digits, 0 and 1. That is, the base or ranks of this system is 2. If we have to compare the decimal number and binary number system, this is a comparison between decimal number system and binary number system. Decimal 0 is binary 0. Decimal 1 is the binary 1. Decimal 2 is the binary 10. Decimal 3 is the binary 11. 4 is 100. 5 is 101. 6 is 110. 7 is 111. 8 is 1000. 9 is 1001, and so on. This is the comparison between decimal digits and the corresponding binary numbers. There is a very simple way to convert a decimal number into the binary number. That is, we have to use the 84214 for this purpose. What is the decimal equivalent of 9? That is, you have to make the addition of the digits in the given code such that it becomes equal to 9. Here 8 plus 1 equal to 9, and therefore you have to write 1 and 1 here, that is the digits which are used. You have to write 1 here, and the digits which does not use, you have to write 2 here. This is the binary equivalent of 9. Suppose we have the number 30, then you have to make the addition of 8 plus 4 plus 1, and that is nothing but 30. So write 1, 1, here is the 1, and 2 is not used, so write 0. That is, this is the binary equivalent of 30. It is a very simple way to convert any decimal number into the corresponding binary number. Suppose the number is larger, for example, we have 21, then its addition does not become 21. Therefore, you have to write next 1 double to that of this, this is 4 is double to the previous. Likewise, 16 is the double to that of the 8. Now, 16 plus 4 plus 1 is 21. Therefore, you have to write 64 and 1. The digits 2 and 8 are not used, you have to write 0 here. And this is nothing but the binary equivalent of 21. By this way, you have to convert any decimal number into the corresponding binary number. It is binary number system is once again a positional bit system, same as that of the decimal number system. We have to take an example. Suppose we have an example of 1011. Then the position bit of this one is a 2 raised to 0. The position weight of this one is a 2 raised to 1. The position weight of 0 is a 2 raised to 2. The position weight of this one is a 2 raised to 3. And so on. These are the 2. Here we have to take the 2 instead of 10, because the base of this system is a 2. In the case of decimal number system, we have to consider 10 raised to 0, 10 raised to 1, and so on. Here is the, suppose another example, that is 1, 1. This point is called as a binary point. In the case of decimal number system, that point is called as a decimal point. Here, the position weight of this one is a 2 raised to minus 1. The position weight of this one is a 2 raised to minus 2, and so on. That is, this number system is once again a positional bit system. And the position bit is given like this. Now we have to see how any decimal number is converted to binary, or binary number is converted to the decimal number. The first thing, conversion that we have to see is the binary to decimal. Binary to decimal. Here simply we have to use the positional bit method for the conversion of binary number to the decimal number. We have to take one example, then you have to get the clear idea about this. That is, suppose the binary number is 1101. Then how we have to convert this number into the decimal number? This digit we call as the most significant bit, while this is called as the least significant bit. This MSB 1 into 2 raised to 3, its a position weight is 2 raised to 3, plus 1 into 2 raised to 2, plus 0 into 2 raised to 1, plus 1 into 2 raised to 0. and this is equal to 8 plus 4 plus 0 plus 1, and that is equal to 13 is the decimal equivalent. Any binary number is converted into the decimal number by using simply a positional weight method. Suppose instead of that example, if you have to consider, here is the 0.11. Then simply for this fractional numbers, we have tried their positional weight 1 into 2 raised to minus 1 plus next 1 into 2 raised to minus 2 and so on. That is, this is 1 divided by 2 plus 1 divided by 2 raised to 2 is nothing but 4. That is, this is nothing but 1 divided by 2 is 0.5 and 1 divided by 4 is nothing but 0.85, and this comes to be 75. That is, 13.75 is the decimal equivalent of this binary number. Thus, any binary number is converted into the decimal number. Next conversion that we have to see is a decimal to binary. Here we have to use a double dagger method for the conversion of decimal number to the binary number. We have to consider, for example, actually the double dagger method is used for the conversion of decimal number to the binary number. Double dagger method, here simply the three steps are used for this conversion. The first thing is that you have to divide the given number by x of 2. The first step is that divide the given number by 2. Write the questions and remainders. The second step is that you have to divide the question every time by 2 till the question becomes equal to 0. And then the third step is that you have to write the questions, you have to write the remainders in upward direction. These are the three steps used for the conversion of decimal number to the binary number. We have to take one example, then you have to get the clear idea about this. Suppose we have a number 37, that is a decimal number 37. We want to convert into the binary number. Then for this given number, you have to divide by 2. Write the quotients and remainders. 37 divided by 2, quotient is 18, remainder is 1. You have to write, or you have to divide this 18, that is quotient, by 2. Now the quotient is 9, remainder is 0. Every time you have to divide the quotient by minus of 2, here is a quotient is 4, remainder is 1. This 4, that is quotient divided by 2, that is the quotient is a 2, remainder is a 0. This 2 divided by 2, that is quotient is 1, remainder is a 0. And now this quotient 1 divided by 2, 1 divided by 2, that is equal to 0, and remainder is 1. You have to write this remainder in upward direction like this. That is, this one as MSB and this one as MSB. Now here 37 decimal is equal to 1001 1001 01. This is the binary equivalent of the given number 37.